We have already used Kirchhoff's loop rule. Hello there. We have already used Kirchhoff's loop rule with this RC circuit to show that zero equals the EMF across the battery minus the electric potential difference across the capacitor minus the electric potential difference across the resistor.
Flippin' physics.
We have also already determined the limits for charge on the capacitor and current in the circuit. The initial charge on the capacitor is zero, and the final charge on the capacitor is at a maximum value of EMF times capacitance. The initial current in the circuit is its maximum value of EMF divided by resistance, and the final current in the circuit is zero. Today we are going to derive equations for charge and current as functions of time in this RC circuit.
Okay, let's start by solving for the charge on the capacitor as a function of time. Here we go. Starting with our Kirchhoff's loop rule equation, we move current times resistance to the other side of the equation. Divide the whole equation by resistance. We know current equals the derivative of charge with respect to time. And actually, let's pause here for a moment. Typically on an AP free response question, where they ask you to solve for something like this, they will actually put it in two parts. First, they ask you to determine a differential equation which can be used to solve for whatever you're solving for. In this case, charge on the capacitor as a function of time. This equation right here, the derivative of charge with respect to time equals electromotive force over resistance minus the charge over the quantity resistance times capacitance, is the answer to that question. This equation is the differential equation which can be used to solve for charge on the capacitor as a function of time. I figured it would be helpful to know that.
It is.
Thanks. Yeah, thanks.
Okay, back to the solution. Our goal here is to get dq and q on the left-hand side of the equation and dt on the right-hand side of the equation so we can take the integral of the whole equation. To do that, we start by getting a common denominator of resistance times capacitance on the right-hand side. We can factor out the inverse of resistance times capacitance, and then factor out a negative 1 from the parenthetical expression on the right-hand side. I do want to point out that this particular step, where we factor out negative 1, is the one step I find students most often forget. So please remember to factor out negative 1 at this point in the derivation.
I'll make a special note of that, Mr. P.
Thank you, Billy. Next, we divide the whole equation by the quantity charge minus electromotive force times capacitance, and we multiply the whole equation by dt. And then we take the integral of the whole equation. On the left-hand side, we are taking the integral with respect to charge, so our limits are in terms of charge. Bobby, what are those limits?
Well, the initial charge on the capacitor is zero, so the initial limit is zero. The final charge on the capacitor is charge maximum, or EMF times capacitance, so EMF times capacitance is the final limit for charge.
Actually, Bobby, I know the final charge on the capacitor is the electromotive force times the capacitance, however, what we are solving for here is the charge as a function of time. So our final limit for the charge is the charge at some time t after we close the switch. In other words, the final limit on charge is the variable lowercase q, which represents the charge at time t. Bobby, what then do you think the integral limits are on the right-hand side?
Okay. On the right-hand side, we are taking the integral with respect to time. So time initial is zero, and time final, time final is just lowercase t, and that represents the time variable in the equation we are solving for, charge as a function of time.
Exactly, Bobby. Thanks. On the right-hand side, resistance and capacitance do not change as a function of time, so we can take those out from the integral. On the left-hand side, the integral with respect to charge of the inverse of the quantity charge minus electromotive force times capacitance is the natural log of the quantity charge minus electromotive force times capacitance.
What? I don't remember that. How do we know that?
That equation is among the common calculus equations on the table of information provided to us by the College Board during the AP exam.
It is? That is helpful. How did I I miss that?
I do not know.
We can substitute in the limits on the left-hand side. And the natural log of x minus the natural log of y equals the natural log of the quantity x divided by y. And the integral of dt from time 0 to time t is just t. So on the right-hand side, we have the negative of time t divided by the quantity resistance times capacitance. And now, we can take e to the power of the whole equation. On the left-hand side, we know e to the power of the natural log of x equals x. So on the left-hand side, we now have charge minus electromotive force times capacitance, all divided by the negative of electromotive force times capacitance. On the right-hand side, we have e to the power, the quantity negative t time t, divided by the quantity resistance times capacitance. Billy, remind me what we are solving for.
We are solving for the charge on the capacitor as a function of time, so we multiply through by negative electromotive force times capacitance, move electromotive force times capacitance to the right-hand side of the equation. We can factor out electromotive force times capacitance, and we have an equation for charge as a function of time when charging a capacitor in an RC circuit.
Very nice, Billy. Notice, this equation fits our limits for charge. When time t equals 0, we get e to the power 0 in the equation. Class, what is the value of e to the power 0?
Negative 1?
1.
0?
E to the power 0 equals 1.
I knew that.
Yes, it does.
Therefore, when time equals 0, this equation shows that the charge on the capacitor is 0. Bo, what about the charge when time equals infinity?
Well, if we plug infinity in for time, we get e to the negative infinity, which is...
0?
Yeah, 0.
Sure, 0.
I feel like you should know all of these numbers.
Yeah, I probably should. So, this equation shows that the charge on the capacitor after roughly an infinite amount of time equals EMF times capacitance. And we already showed that equals the maximum charge of the capacitor. Yeah, we could substitute charge maximum into the equation for charge as a function of time.
Thanks, Bo. This is the graph for charging an initially uncharged capacitor through a resistor as a function of time. You can see the initial charge is 0, the charge on the capacitor increases according to the equation we solved for, and it asymptotes to the maximum charge, which is equal to electromotive force times capacitance. Bobby, please solve for the current in the circuit as a function of time.
Okay,
current equals the derivative of charge with respect to time.
Sure.
And we now have an equation for the charge on the capacitor as a function of time.
Right. We can substitute the equation for charge we just solved for into that equation.
Actually, could you go back a few steps and use EMF times capacitance minus EMF times capacitance times e to the power negative time over the quantity resistance times capacitance, please?
Okay. EMF and capacitance are both constant as a function of time, so the derivative of that is 0. And we can take EMF times capacitance out from the derivative. The derivative of e to the power negative time over resistance times capacitance. The equation for this is also on the table of information. That means the derivative of e to the power negative time over resistance times capacitance equals negative 1 over resistance times capacitance, all times e to the power negative time over resistance times capacitance. So the current through the circuit as a function of time equals EMF over resistance times e to the power negative time over resistance times capacitance.
Well done, Bobby. Billy, please determine the limits of the current through the RC circuit.
Certainly. When we substitute 0 in for time t into the equation for current, we get e to the negative 0, which equals 1. So the initial current in the RC circuit equals electromotive force divided by resistance. And we already determined that is the maximum current, so we can substitute current maximum back into the equation for current as a function of time. And for the limit after a long time, We can substitute infinity in for time in the current equation. E to the negative infinity equals zero, so the current in the RC circuit is zero after a long time, which is what we got before.
Thank you, Billy. And this is the graph for that equation. You can see the initial current is at a maximum value of electromotive force divided by resistance, and the current decreases according to the equation we solved for and asymptotes at a current of zero. So notice that, according to both of our graphs, after a long time, the RC circuit reaches a steady state condition where the charge across the capacitor is at its maximum value. Realize the electric potential difference is also steady at its maximum value. We know this because the electric potential difference across the capacitor equals the charge on the capacitor divided by its capacitance. The charge has reached a steady state, and the capacitance of the capacitor is constant, therefore the electric potential difference has also reached a steady state. This also means that, after a long time, the current through the circuit has reached a steady state value of zero. And the electric potential difference across the resistor is also zero because it equals current times resistance, and the current through the resistor has a constant value of zero.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.